I remember as a child that my parents were both active. My mother was active in the Women's League of the ANC. My father used to work for the municipality as one of the first, traffic inspectors. And he used to, every time in his motorbike, greet us with a clenched fist, and my boy Africa, and so on. And so I think the home was abuzz with politics from a very young age. But then, of course, there came the silence of the 60s. People didn't want to talk about politics after the arrest of the leadership of the African National Congress. Earlier on, there had been activities, the bus boycotts, the schools boycotts at the introduction of Bantu education, just about when I went to school myself. I remember I was at school with Zwelakhe Sisulu, and we had a little group there discussing alternatives, what we could do. When I got to university, of course, the South African Students Organization, SASO, was formed. I was at the University of Zululand. Steve Biko, Bali Pichana, I think, and others came to school to launch the branch of SASO there. And we all joined. We were all excited that at least there could be some exploitation of the situation there, because the African National Congress had been banned, and here was some novel way in which we could try to get involved in politics without espousing what the African National Congress was espousing at that time, which was a forceful overthrow of the apartheid regime. What motivated me to be involved in politics was, of course, the launch of the South African Students Organization. Because before that launch, we were all of us trying to search. When there was a vehicle now to propagate what we could propagate then, which was peaceful resistance to apartheid, inculcating in Africans a sense of pride and of their ability to resist in themselves and not to seek solutions elsewhere. We thought it was a worthy platform, and we threw ourselves into that effort. Well, I left the year that the Soweto uprisings took place. There were bubblings in the townships. I was an activist, underground activist of the African National Congress, recruiting for the ANC. And it was, in fact, I can't say that I was recruiting for the ANC, because everybody was just ready to join the ANC. So it was no effort at all. I can't remember approaching a single person and motivating them to great lengths about joining the African National Congress's Umkhonto weSizwe, because people were just ready. People were angry, and people wanted to fight. So in a way, the seeds of the Soweto uprisings had been sown for so long. At the inception of Bantu education, everything that had happened before then, the repression that had followed the jailing of our leaders and the exiling of many of them. In fact, we had gone to Botswana to attend, me and a few friends of mine, to attend the funeral of Nkgopo Tsetiro, who had been assassinated there. Because we wanted to join the African, we were looking for the ANC. Before June 1976, following the liberation of Mozambique, or following the deposal of the Salazar regime in Portugal, or the death of Antonio Salazar, we were looking for the ANC, because the cordon sanitaire that South Africa enjoyed in Mozambique was almost broken now. It was a very satisfying moment in the lives of South African black people, especially. I voted in Soweto, where I lived in Dubai. That first vote was so important. That queuing on that day was so important. if there is a regression, there's very little of it. Of course, we have not achieved. I said that it was a milestone, the voting. And as much as Mandela put it, you know, he has climbed that hill to only to rest and look back survey the vistas. But it does not mean it's the end of the journey. In fact, the journeys going forward are more difficult than the one that we have traversed. The issue of total liberation, the issue of achieving equality, still escapes us. We have not reached that point. Obviously, we did not believe that we would address all the vestiges and of apartheid and solve them in 20 years, and that the road would be long. And I believe that Mandela was correct that the road is going to be long going forward and more difficult than the road that we had gone through. I receive a meager pension. I can't live on that pension, so I still strive. And so the other time I was listening to somebody saying, you know, the thing about Zola Skoia is not writing and so on, these people are not writing. I said, you know, these people think Rikwala Gamamina. Rikwala Gamamina, Rikwala Ga ink. And that ink you have to buy. The paper that you have to write on, you have to buy. You have to have resources in order to have a book. But I am writing. And at some point, I hope I will pass.